Hello and welcome. You're watching today's headlines with me, Karan Thapar. It's that time of day when you get our take on the biggest news stories, minus, of course, the hype and the noise. Our top focus today is on the devastation in Jammu and Kashmir, which is experiencing its worst ever flood fury since 1959. Yesterday, Prime Minister Narendra Modi declared the flood situation a national level disaster. But the PM's declaration has done little for those stranded and seeking relief. The death toll has crossed 200 and most of Srinagar still remains underwater. The Army, Navy and the Air Force are struggling to provide relief. The only respite for now is that the continuous rains seem to have stopped.
Jammu and Kashmir battling one of the worst floods in decades. 5 days of continuous downpour, leaving death and devastation in its wake. Situation in Srinagar evoking memories of Kedarnath. Most parts of the city underwater, a swollen Jhelum turning the city into a giant Dal Lake. Massive rescue operations are underway to evacuate those stranded. People waiting for rescue on terraces and rooftops, unable to reach safer places.
Kashmir Valley has been virtually flowed under, and a lot of households have been stuck in their particular houses. This is one of the houses in Nigin Bagh area, and we have managed to enter this house with great difficulty. People trapped inside their houses on the upper floors.
Two three days ho gaye hain, zyada flood aa raha hai, kal se zyada hua.
Khane peene ka intezam thoda intezam hai hamare paas.
The 1,000 crore rupee central aid seems immaterial as thousands flee Srinagar, their belongings strewn on road, children and women crying for help.
Flood is evident on the ground here. Look at these people. They are out on the streets, out of their houses. This is the foreshore road of Srinagar, and all the adjoining areas have been flooded, and people have been forced to come out of their houses. Look at these children, most of them crying, tears in their eyes. Not just the children, even the elders, the women, elderly people, all the family members out on the streets with no help from anyone. Government is absolutely missing on the ground. Nobody is coming here to help these people.
After an overnight communication blackout, links have been restored to the valley. But areas like Pulwama, Anantnag and Shopian in south and central Kashmir are still unreachable, with roads and bridges swept away.
We are not being able to establish communications with our teams who are operating there, those who are operating in rescuing people. And second is, in some of the areas the water is so high and water level is so high that we are not being able to reach there unless we are airlifted. So these are two big challenges.
There is massive damage to the state's power infrastructure. 750 transformers, 13,000 poles and over 24 high-tension transmission towers have been completely destroyed, a majority of them in the valley alone. In Jammu, some relief in sight for Vaishno Devi pilgrims. The yatra has resumed after 13 kilometers of the track was restored.
The Vaishno Devi Yatra, which was suspended for the past several days because of bad weather and heavy rainfall in and around areas adjoining Jammu, has finally resumed today, and you can see the heavy rush as the news spread just a few minutes back that the Yatra has resumed. People have rushed from all corners of Katra to queue up for the registration of the Yatra and to continue their Yatra. Many of these people have been stuck here in Katra for the past several days waiting for the yatra to resume. Let's talk to some of them are present here. Aap ye bataiye kitne dinon se aap yahan ruke hue the yatra ke liye?
Ji hum to yahan se 4 tarikh ko aaye hue hain, abhi tak ruke hue hain yatra ke liye, abhi tak mata se darshan nahi hue hain.
To abhi yatra shuru ho gayi hai, to kya ab aapko khushi mehsoos ho rahi hai ki?
Ji bahut khushi mehsoos ho rahi hai. 4 tarikh se hum log Nalanda jila Bihar se aaye hue hain, bahut khushi mehsoos ho rahi hai.
On the weather front, there is relief with a dry spell forecast in the next few days. A welcome change from the two western disturbances, which led to very heavy downpour in the last few days. Bureau Report, Headlines Today.
The worst floods ever witnessed in the history of the Kashmir Valley. And you can see we are flying over Srinagar and areas that are full with water, flooded. Those are the areas where actually people have not been able to be rescued. Thousands of them are struck. Lakhs have been dispossessed of their houses, and the NDRF and the army is trying. It's a historic flood situation in Jammu and Kashmir. We are at the Srinagar airport, the capital of Jammu and Kashmir. The airport bears a deserted look. Usually during this season, you can see the airport flooded with tourists. But today, only a handful of people coming in and out. More of administration vehicles and officers, army officers, you can spot around the airport. And there is a problem with conveyance and coming out of the airport and going along long distance, because we believe that the airport, outside the airport, the area is inundated with water, and there are people who have come from far away to get to their family members. We have with us Ashish, who is actually really hassled and worried because he doesn't know where his parents are. Ashish,
I'm calling my parents from bus 3 days, and there is nobody picking up. वो लोग जवाहर नगर में ही हैं, रहते हैं. I think वहीं फंसे हैं, और वहाँ पर पानी एक-एक फ्लोर तक आ गया है, और अभी तक कोई न्यूज़ नहीं है.
How tough is this operation? Because we do believe that there are rescue teams by the army, the NDRF. So what is the Air Force job?
See, Air Force is basically giving the air support and air rescue. Our mandate is to provide relief material to the people who are stranded, and whomsoever we can rescue from rooftops, we are doing it by winching. Okay. So today we have undertaken about 18 sorties and rescued about 100 odd civilians from different areas around in Srinagar.
The view is dismal. There are people who are stranded sitting by the footpath. They are just hoping against hope that they would be getting back home. These are the workers from Bihar who have fled from the Rambagh area, and you can see they are huddled in one blanket, four or five of them. Some don't even have a blanket, in the open sky, sitting here in the cold.
हम लोग बहुत मुश्किल से निकल कर अपना जान बचा करके हम लोग यहाँ तक पहुँचे हैं. हम लोग को यहाँ ना गवर्नमेंट की कोई सुविधा मिली है, और ना ही हम लोग को यहाँ कोई अभी तक कोई सुविधा दिया गया है.
फूड आइटम ज़रूर चाहिए, प्लस घर टूट चुके हैं सबके. एक शेल्टर ज़रूर होना चाहिए, क्योंकि अगर शेल्टर नहीं होगा तो रात को ठंड बहुत बढ़ जाती है, तो लोगों को बहुत दिक्कत फेस करनी पड़ रही है.
आप सुन रहे हैं, यू कैन हियर ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ पीपल आर लिविंग अंडर द ओपन स्काई एंड दे स्लीपिंग देयर. दे हैव नो फूड, दे हैव नो हेल्प. सो द रेस्क्यू ऑपरेशंस आर द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट. फर्स्ट द रेस्क्यू एंड देन द रिलीफ, एंड एट द सेम टाइम पीपल नीड फूड. इट्स बीन 7 days एंड द टॉयल इज ऑन, द टर्मोइल इज ऑन, एंड पीपल आर जस्ट होपिंग दैट दे विल सी अ बेटर डे. विद कैमरा पर्सन रविकांत, दिस इज मौसमी सिंह इन श्रीनगर for headlines today.
As always in a disaster, the Indian Defence Forces have been at the forefront carrying out rescue operations. The ongoing relief operations today got a fresh impetus with the Chief of Army Staff's statement that the Indian Army will not move back into its barracks till the last man is brought to safety.
The deadliest floods in Jammu and Kashmir's living memory. On one side, in an epic battle to save thousands, with the number of confirmed dead at over 160, this is a humanitarian operation on a war footing. With the Indian Navy joining the effort today with 200 Marine Commandos, the race against time is now a massive operation, extending across the three armed forces in three dimensions. The war against the deadly floods in the state is being led by 212 specialized army columns, comprising of 20,000 troops, reaching out to the most marooned areas. The Indian Air Force is using 23 aircraft to haul desperately needed relief material to the state, while 26 helicopters conduct round-the-clock evacuations, and 10 deadly Marine Commando teams have now joined the fight. Like these dramatic images from Rajouri district, the army is attempting to respond to all distress calls as quickly as possible.
हमें अक्सर ऐसे टास्क मिलते रहते हैं कि हम पानी में, मतलब कि जैसे एनडीआरएफ वाले काम करते हैं, वैसे हम भी कहीं भी कुछ भी रेस्क्यू का प्रॉब्लम आता है तो हमें बुलाया जाता है, जब सबके हाथों से चीज़ निकल जाती है तो।
चार दिन से फंसा हुआ इधर, और आदमी बहुत मदद किया और यहाँ से निकाला हमारे को। बहुत गहरा नाला है, बहुत बसी पानी है, तीन चार दिन से रोटी पानी का परेशानी थी।
Most rescue operations will remain unseen and unrecorded because that's just how deep into the military effort has gone. Today, the Air Force will airlift 83 tons of emergency rations, 3,000 blankets, 45,000 litres of potable water, 1,000 life jackets and 220 tents to Srinagar from Chandigarh, Pathankot and Kanpur. Given the enormous damage to infrastructure, that's also impending rescue operations and access to remote affected areas, a specialized combat engineer task force has been rushed from Delhi to the flood affected areas to scale up the effort. Marooned without food or supplies for days, reaching the thousands still stranded in now an unforgiving race against time. Bureau Report, Headlines Today.
One disaster and the Indo-Pak Cold War of just a few weeks ago has begun to thaw. The floods have caused as much destruction in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir as they have on the Indian side. Thousands are still trapped, waiting to be rescued on both sides of the border. Putting aside past differences and the tea with separatist incident that marred ties, both nations have offered to help each other at this time of crisis. The rival neighbors stand united, at least in the face of tragedy.
Nature's fury knows no boundaries. Flash floods triggered by heavy rain have wreaked havoc both in India and Pakistan. There's death and destruction on both sides, the two countries united in tragedy. More than 300 people have lost their lives in the flood-ravaged areas of Jammu and Kashmir and Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. The death toll in Pakistan is 170 and is feared to go up. In Jammu and Kashmir, more than 150 people have been reported dead in the last 6 days. Seeing the extent of devastation in Pakistan, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has reached out to his counterpart Nawaz Sharif. India has offered assistance in flood relief operations to Pakistan in areas across the line of control. Writing to Nawaz Sharif on Sunday, Narendra Modi said that India's resources were at Pakistan's disposal whenever it needed them. But the government's Pakistan outreach is being seen as no more than a humanitarian gesture. Pakistan too has offered help to India. In response to New Delhi's gesture, Islamabad said it was ready to help India in whatever way possible. Neither of the two countries have so far accepted the offer of help. But after the suspension of talks, the big humanitarian gesture by India and Pakistan may prove to be the thaw in relations between the two countries. Bureau Report, Headlines Today.
The face-off between CBI Chief Ranjit Sinha and Prashant Bhushan is getting curiouser by the day. The country's premier investigative agency is fending off a volley of allegations by Bhushan with its own set of questions. This even as Sinha faced a major setback in the Supreme Court, being told that all major decisions taken by him would be cancelled if Guestgate allegations against him were proven.
In the war between CBI Chief Ranjit Sinha and anti-corruption crusader Prashant Bhushan, the first round has gone to Bhushan. Ranjit Sinha leaving house for his day in the Supreme Court, for a day that would end up with him on the back foot, with the court going ahead with the hearing on charges that Sinha met various scam accused.
In an interesting development, Prashant Bhushan surrendered to the Supreme Court's custody what he claims to be the original guest register from CBI Chief Ranjit Sinha's residence, claiming that two people who refused to identify themselves dropped it off at his residence on Sunday evening, saying it's a crucial piece of evidence that could be destroyed. Meanwhile, the Supreme Court has granted Ranjit Sinha 1 week's time to respond to the allegations made against him.
Interestingly, it is this visitor's diary that you first saw on headlines today last week, being used as prime evidence by Bhushan in the Supreme Court hearing. Now the same is being targeted by the CBI. The CBI has maintained throughout that there was no visitor's log maintained at the CBI chief's residence. The agency has also said that those being targeted by it could be behind Bhushan's NGO to settle scores. Lastly, the agency has also pointed out at various discrepancies in the logs submitted to the Supreme Court. According to the CBI, The logs seem to be doctored with various car numbers shown in the records, not even in existence. Delhi police records show that as many as 40 vehicles shown in the guest list do not exist. There are numerous other inconsistencies in the guest list as well, with timing overlaps, suggesting the CBI chief was meeting several presumably unrelated guests at the same time. The agency has raised questions over the in and out times of the guests as well. It's not only Ranjit Sinha who is watching the case with bated breath. Even for the political class, the ruling, as well as those in the opposition, it's a high-stakes outcome. After all, in the 21 months, the CBI has gone full throttle in several high-profile cases with links to those in the ruling class. With Jaskirat Singh Bawa in Delhi, Shujoy, Headlines Today.